first things you'll do when processing scabiosa is to fill a vase with warm, almost hot water with the correct amount of floral food for however much scabiosa you're processing. I choose a vase that's double the height, sometimes even a little bit taller depending on how much I have, just so I make sure that the heads of the flowers are correctly propped up and they're not bending over. They're just sitting upright easily in the vase. So yeah, warm to hot water. And the reason I choose warm to hot water is because usually they have a little bit harder time drinking after getting them home from the market or the grocery store or wherever you're buying your flowers from. So they totally work well with warm to hot water. I don't use cold because they just don't hydrate that well with it. That's just my personal experience. A lot of flower shops that I've worked for in the past only had cold water, so you do what you have, but ideally warm to hot water. Try warm, and if it doesn't look like they're hydrating, then go for hot. So I first start by removing all of the laterals, and I set those aside because I'll put those in a separate vase. Just being careful not to crack the bloom off of the original stem. So then I'm left with just one long bloom. And like all of our other things that we process and condition, we give it a nice long cut at a 10 degree angle and place it into the water.
I'm gonna clean off all of this greenery, and this is personal preference, design preference. Option here, you can either leave all of these laterals on or strip them off. I personally like to strip them off because I want all of the hydration and flower food to go to the main bloom here. And I also don't really tend to use the laterals in my design work because of the pave nature of how I design. If I'm doing something a little bit more wild, I might leave them on, but even still, I would probably take them off. And then if I wanted to put them into my design, I would have them in a separate vase. And you're kind of doing a pulling down motion. That is the easiest way to get these little pieces of foliage off. Same with the laterals, kind of bend and pull in the opposite direction. That way it just snaps right off. You don't have to use snippers or a floral knife for that. You can if you want, but it's easier and more time efficient if you just go ahead in with your hands and bend them in the backwards direction, bending backwards and down. And that should make it really easy for you to process and condition your flowers in a very time efficient manner. Bending backwards, pulling down. Bending backwards, pulling down. Bending backwards, pulling down. Bending backwards, pulling down. It's the same action over and over and over again. And once you get the hang of that, it becomes super easy. Most flowers are going to prefer that specific action. And then when it comes to a lateral, I'll hold steady the stem and the bloom so that it doesn't rip off the bloom from the main stem here. So just holding that at the place where they intersect and take off. That way your stem is still intact, your bloom is still on the main stem. You may want to just keep an eye out as you're doing this, again, so that you're not taking the main bloom off of the main stem. So you're kind of just paying attention as you're doing it so you're not ruining your stem and you're keeping as much length on it as possible if that's what you need it for.
So now I'm going to do the same with the laterals that I broke off here. It's the same exact process. It's just a little bit time consuming, but if you are making a more wild arrangement, I do recommend taking off the laterals and processing them into their own separate vase, because that way you have a lot more control over the way your design looks. If you just leave these on the stem, it's going to constrict how how you design, or it's not going to be as specific as you want it to be. So if you're using these in your design, strip them off the main stem, clean them up, processing condition as you would the other stems, and then that way you can make an arrangement of them unto themselves, or you can incorporate them into one of your more wild designs, or you can even use them as a little accent detail buttons if you're doing a pave look. That's what I do, and funny that I called it a button, because when I'm doing these pave designs, I tend to think of it like a couture custom handmade garment. That's what I'm always seeing, and that's what I'm really inspired most by, are couture fabrics, like some of the Givenchy collections. Handmade, beaded, beautiful, abundant detail. I tend to think of my pave designs in that way. They're heavily textured and varied in size and shape, and that's what these little tiny button pieces are going to give you in your pave designs as well. Yes, it's extremely time consuming, but if you price your work correctly, you will make money on your designs. So again, you're kind of bending backwards, pulling it down for all of the little foliage. And then you will process. This is longer, so I'm gonna put that in with the big boys. Stripping off the little stems. Same theory across the board, just making sure that none of the foliage is in the water. But as I'm processing, I'm like kind of twisting the stem to make sure that all of those little pieces are off. So it's like twisting. Left hand twists, right hand kind of pulls off any of the foliage or debris that needs to come off. Left hand keeps it stable, right hand is doing the processing, and then I keep my knife in my hand and cut when it's ready. So now we are going to finish conditioning our flowers by misting them with Floralife Finishing Touch. This is my favorite spray to use for locking in moisture on my flowers. It helps a lot. I do not design or process without using this, and I highly recommend it. You can find it in my store link below, and that way you have easy access. You can get it shipped directly to you from Amazon. So if you want to support this channel, feel free to shop in that link below. So shake the bottle, hold it 12 inches away from your floral product, give it a nice mist, making sure to get all parts of the flower as well as the stem, because the stem will take in moisture as well. I turn the base as I go, making sure that it gets all the angles, and that's great. You can also find this particular marble Lazy Susan in my store in that Amazon link as well. This Lazy Susan is not appropriate for all design work or all processing work. It is pretty delicate. I haven't broken it yet, but if you're a little bit rougher, kind of, you know, you're quick processing, in most flower shops, they're not going to be using a marble Lazy Susan. It's probably plastic or wood or something that's really sturdy and not prone to breakage, but I love the look of marble, and I treat it nicely, and it has lasted really well. I just don't put huge arrangements on it, and I don't put super heavy bases of water on it. So it's about 12 inch Lazy Susan there. They come in the larger size, and yeah, all that's linked below.